Hi students, today let us study the Chaffetz method. Chaffetz method is used to solve the non-linear partial differential equations. Okay, what is its procedure? First, any given function f x y z p q which is equal to 0, this is general form of writing the partial differential equations. If it is a non-linear partial differential equation, means whose degree is more than 1, so then we will, to solve that type of the partial differential equations, we will use the method called as Chaffetz method. We will see the procedure. First step is this, convert in the standard form given question and then write it is in this form, dx divided by minus dou f by dou p, which is equal to dy divided by minus dou f by dou q is equal to dz divided by minus p into dou f by dou p minus q into dou f by dou q, which is equal to dp divided by dou f by dou x, okay, plus p into dou f by dou z, which is equal to dq divided by dou f by dou y plus q into dou f by dou z. First, write it in this standard form and find all these partial derivatives, those nothing but dou f by dou p, dou f by dou q, right? Dou f by dou x, dou f by dou z, dou f by dou y. Find all these 5 partial derivatives and substitute it in this formula. And then consider any one, any two of these fractions and integrate to find the value of, okay, to find the value of p, okay, or q or both, okay. If you suppose find it the value of p, now to find the value of q in given function only, just substitute the value of p and find the value of q, or vice versa. If you find it first considering any two fractions, if you find it the value of q, to find the value of p in this function, substitute its value, okay, of q, you are going to find p, or both the values of p q can find from these fractions only, from first step only. Once you find the value of p and q, third step is consider dz is equal to p into dx plus q into dy. Substitute the value of p and q in this formula and then on integrate. We are going to get the required solution of non-linear partial differential equation. This is its procedure. Let us consider one example. How they will give? Find the complete integral of px plus qy is equal to pq. So how to solve this one? First, write in the standard form, write everything to the left side. So px plus qy minus pq is equal to 0. I will keep this one as equation 1. Once you written this, write down its formula, dx divided by minus dou f by dou p is equal to divided by 1 minus dou f by dou q is equal to dz divided by minus p into dou f by dou p minus q into dou f by dou q, okay, which is equal to dp divided by, okay, dou f by dou x plus p into dou f by dou z, which is equal to dq divided by dou f by dou y plus q into dou f by dou z. Okay, I will keep this one as equation 2. So what we will find out first, dou f by dou p What is your dou f by means partially differentiate equation 1 with respect to p. What you are going to get here? Px means you are going to get as x. Okay, plus this qy will become 0, and this minus pq with respect to p means minus. So this is minus q. So this is dou f by dou p is nothing but x minus q, comma dou f by dou q is going to be equal to with respect to q. Equation 1 partial differentiate with respect to q. So that time px will become 0 and your qy will become as y minus this pq will become as p. So this is your dou f by dou q. Similarly, dou f by dou x means equation 1 partially differentiate with respect to x. So here you have the x term, so it will be p, comma dou f by dou z I want. So it means z term you don't have in this equation 1, so it will be 0. Similarly, dou f by dou y, partially differentiate this function equation 1 with respect to y. Y term here you have q, so you are going to get as q. So these are its values. Substitute in equation 2. What you are going to get here? It is dx divided by minus dou f by this dou p, that is nothing but x minus q, which is equal to dy divided by minus dou f by dou q, nothing but it is y minus p, which is equal to dz divided by minus p into x minus q minus, substitute in this formula, that is equation 2, q into bracket, it is y minus p, which is equal to dp divided by, what is dou f by dou x, it is going to be as p plus it is p into 0, because dou f by dou z is 0, which is equal to dou q by, it is going to be considered as q plus q into 0. So I will keep this one as equation 3. Now we need to consider from this equation 3 any two fractions to find the value of p and q. So I will consider fourth and fifth fractions. Nothing but we are going to consider dp by p is equal to dq by q from equation 3. So on integrating, what we are going to get here? On integrating, so it will be log p, because 1 by p into dp, 1 by x with respect to x is log x. Similarly, 1 by p with respect to p integration is log p, which is equal to, similarly, 1 by q into dq, it means become as log q plus some integrating constant, we will write log a. Solve this, it is log p going to be equal to log a plus log b, it is log a into b. So I will write log q into a. Just cancel this, p is equal to qa. Now what I will do, because the equation 3 fractions are complicated, I will value of this p, we will put in equation 1. P is equal to qa, put in equation 1 to find the value of q. Okay, so what is our equation 1? It is px. So p means q, okay, it is aq x plus qy, qy as it is minus pq. So it is apq is equal to 0. When you substitute in equation 1, we are going to get this. So, sorry, p means you are going to get as aq. So this will become as aq square is equal to 0. Solve this and simplify. You are going to get the value of, so you can write as here, q take common from these two, you are going to get the term as ax plus qy, which is equal to, you shift this one to the right side, so it will become as aq square. Cancel 1q from this. It is ax plus qy is equal to, it is going to be as aq. Okay, you want the value of q. So q is equal to here, this ax sorry, here it is going to be as y. So it is q is equal to ax plus y whole divided by a. So this is your value of q. Find out the value of q. The value of q in terms of x, y is there, but the value of p, it is in terms of q. So first find the value of p again using this. P is equal to q value means substitute is ax plus y by a into here a you write it, cancel this a. So that implies p value is going to be as it is ax plus y. So we find it means we converted p value also in terms of xy, q value already we got in terms of xy. Then what we will do it is we will consider the equation dz is equal to p into dx plus q into dy. So here substitute the values of p and q. So what is the value of p? We got this ax plus y into dx plus what is the value of q? Ax plus y divided by a into dy. Take LCM, it is a, so it is going to be written as a into ax plus y into dx plus it is ax plus y into dy whole divided by a, and that a shifted the left side, so it is will become a into dz is equal to this. So a into dz is equal to what we will do, I will take ax plus y as common, in the bracket remains a into dx plus it is going to be as dy, nothing but we can write a into dz is equal to it is ax plus y, even you can write d of it is ax plus y. Once you written this, for my reference I will keep this one as equation 4. Once you written this one, before integrating, just I will simplify this function. Consider here u is equal to ax plus y. Then what happens? It is a into dz is equal to it is u into du. Now on integrating, what happens to this? So it will become as a into z, because with respect to z, a is the constant, integrating of that is going to be z. So a into z is equal to u with respect to u, x with respect to x square by 2. So this is u square by 2 plus some integrating constant. So I will write that integrating constant is b. Now what I will do, I will convert now solution in terms of x, y, z. So it is az is equal to what is u means? We know that already u means this. That is ax plus y. We will write this as ax plus y the whole square divided by 2 plus some integrating constant. So this is your final solutions of PDE. Thank you.